Yesterday only when I was explaining you what about how you have to put it down, that is in the flow chart. Yes or no? In a flow chart you have to write it down. Then now, how many events are there in sexual reproduction? Until now you will have studied about what is sexual reproduction. Yes or no? About the seasonal breeders you studied, about the continuous breeders you studied. Now we will be studying about what is the sexual reproduction and what are the events in it. There are three events. How many events? There are three events. Three events in the sexual reproduction process. Yes or no? There are three events in the sexual reproduction process. In that, the first event is pre-fertilization event. Second one is fertilization, and the third one is post-fertilization event. First one is pre-fertilization event. Second one is fertilization event, and the third one is post-fertilization event. In pre-fertilization event, it is subdivided into gametogenesis and gamete transfer. What it is divided into? Gametogenesis and gamete transfer. What it is? Pre-fertilization event. And post-fertilization event is zygote and zygote formation and embryogenesis. Zygote formation and embryogenesis. Okay. Zygote formation and embryogenesis. Now you will be asking me, ma'am, what is this pre-fertilization, fertilization and post-fertilization? So it is very clear, the events which occur before the fertilization process, the events which occur before the fertilization process is pre-fertilization events. Understanding? The events which occur before fertilization is pre-fertilization events, and the events which occur after fertilization process is post-fertilization events. Understood? Before and after. Okay, before and after. Pre-fertilization are before. Pre-fertilization are before fertilization. Before fertilization, and post-fertilization is after fertilization. Yes, clear. Before fertilization and after fertilization. So you have to remember this. The events which occur before fertilization is pre-fertilization, and the events which occur after fertilization is post-fertilization event. Okay. Now, in pre-fertilization, there are two types, gametogenesis and gamete transfer. Okay. Gametogenesis and gamete transfer. And in a post-fertilization event, it is zygote formation and embryogenesis. So, yes, someone asks me, what is fertilization? Now, what is this fertilization? Okay, now I'm telling you again and again, pre-fertilization, post-fertilization. So, here, you have to know what is fertilization process first. Yes or no? So, we'll go on to the... We'll move on to the next slides where you can understand it very clearly. Okay, you can understand it very clearly. Now here what happens in a fertilization process, both male and female gametes is involved. What is involved? Male and female gametes is involved. So fertilization is basically the fusion, okay, the fusion of the male and the female gamete to give zygote. Okay, the zygote or the embryo. So what is fertilization? Fertilization is nothing but the fusion of, you can write down and take, the fusion of male and female gametes to give zygote or the embryo. Okay. Understood, students? Okay. What is fertilization? So what happens in the sexual fertilization? Sexual reproduction. What happens in the sexual reproduction? There is this the fusion, yes or no, the involvement of the male and the female gamete as well. I had explained you what is sexual reproduction, yes or no. So what happens in the fusion, in the fertilization? The fusion, that means the meeting, fusion or the meeting, or I can say where they meet. Okay, the fusion of the male and female gamete to give zygote or the embryo is known as fertilization. Okay, is known as fertilization. As we move forward, there are a few of the slides where you can clearly understand the entire process. Now you just remember what is fertilization in your very own words. What it is? Fertilization is nothing but the fusion of male and female gamete to give zygote or the embryo is called as fertilization. Is it clear, students? Is it clear to everyone? What is fertilization? Fusion of male and female gamete to give out a zygote or the embryo is called as fertilization. So here, before the fusion, the events which take place is gametogenesis and gamete transfer, and after the fusion, the events take place is zygote formation and embryogenesis. Okay, zygote formation and embryogenesis. Now, first we will be discussing about the pre-fertilization event. Okay, what we will be discussing about? We will be discussing about the pre-fertilization event. And in pre-fertilization events, there are two types, gametogenesis and gamete transfer. Please note down and take. Okay, so what it is, pre-fertilization event? The events of sexual reproduction that occur before fertilization. The events of sexual reproduction that occurs before fertilization. Your understanding, is it getting clear to you? Means what I'm trying to say here is the events, whatever events which are occurring in the sexual reproduction that are occurring before the fertilization process are the pre-fertilization, means before. Okay, before the fertilization process, whatever the events occur, that are known as pre-fertilization events. Now, the pre-fertilization events are of how many types? Two types. One is gametogenesis, one is gamete transfer. What it is? Gametogenesis and gamete transfer. Is it clear, students? Gametogenesis and gamete transfer. Now, let us study what is gametogenesis. Okay, let us study what is gametogenesis. Now, what it is, let us know first it in a very easy thing so that you'll remember the definition. It is important, okay, students? It is very important for you to learn the definitions in this particular chapter. I have told you, right, in this particular chapter, there are many such definitions, differentiations, differences you will get. So it is very important for you to know this few of the very important definitions and the examples. Okay. So let us first start with this gametogenesis. Now what it is? It is the process of formation of male and female gametes. Understanding? The process where the male and the female gametes form. Okay. The process where the male and the female gametes form is known as gametogenesis. Okay. Is known as gametogenesis. The process of male and female gametes is known as gametogenesis. Write down and take. Okay. The process of formation of male and female gametes is known as gametogenesis. Now, will you remember this? What is gametogenesis? Gametogenesis means just keep in mind that it is something regarding the formation. Okay. It is something where it forms. Okay. So here, gametogenesis means formation of male and female gametes. Gametes are specialized haploid cells formed after the meiotic cell division. Now, what are these gametes? Okay, what are these gametes? Gametes are nothing but the reproductive part, or I can say, okay, gametes are nothing but the reproductive part or those reproductive cells which helps in the formation or producing the embryo, the zygote. Okay, now what are these? Gametes are specialized haploid cells. Haploid cells means 1N. You are all aware about it. Yes or no, 1N? All of you have studied the cell cycle lesson. You have studied very clearly meiosis, mitosis. Yes or no? 1N means it is a haploid cell. Yes or no? It is a haploid cell. Now, what do you mean by haploid cell? It has got only one set of chromosome. It has got only one set of chromosome. Yes or no? The cell has got only one set of chromosome. Very good. So here, the gametes are the specialized haploid cell. Haploid means those cells which has got only one set of chromosome, formed after meiotic cell division. Students, meiotic is a which type of cell division? Students, time and again, this question about homogametes, heterogametes, or isogametes and anisogametes question is asked. Okay, once again, I'm saying you, it is important. Write down anything. Now, why I'm saying you this is important? Because in this lesson, again, I'm repeating, there are many differences, and differences is asked for 2 marks. Okay. Majorly, the differences are asked for 2 marks. Now, when I say it is asked for 2 marks, you need to give one difference and at least one example. Okay, so you must write down the examples and take important. Is it clear? Examples and take important. Now, what do you mean by this? Isogametes or homogametes, anisogametes or heterogametes? Okay, can anyone different? So it is also known as isogametes. So what I'm saying you here is isogametes or homogametes, where both male and female gametes are morphologically similar, means the external structure of the gametes is similar. The external structure of the gamete is similar. An example is cladophora. Okay, example is cladophora, and the picture is here. Can you see here, students? The picture is here. This is a kind of a small grass-like structure, moss-like structure. Can you see? It is an algae. Okay. It is an algae. And the example is cladophora. Pictureize yourself. Imagine and then understand and write. So it becomes easy for you. Okay. So what do you mean by homogamete? Homogamete means where both male and female gametes, both male and female gametes are morphologically similar. An example is cladophora. Okay, example is cladophora. Please note down and take. Okay. Next, coming to anisogametes or heterogametes. Hetero means different, you said? Yes. Now, what do you mean by this? Both female and male gametes are morphologically different, means they are different in structure, external structure. Okay, external structure. Both female and male gametes are morphologically different. Example is fucus. And that is also alga, and this is the example. Fucus. Can you see? It is a brown algae. Okay, it is a brown algae. You must have seen it near the seashore or near the rocks in some of the rivers and all, which makes it brown. Do you remember when we were studying about the algae in the first year, we have discussed about fucus, yes or no, in the different algae. If it is brown color pigmentation, then what it is called as? If it is a brown color pigmentation, yes, the brown algae is known as what? Rhodophyceae is for, Rhodophyceae is for red algae. Yes, very good. Then xanthophyll is for, xanthophyll is for students. Okay, you can go through it once and come and tell me in the next class, because I want you people to go through those notes. It's because it's very important for you to know about the algae as well. So, okay, let me move forward where heterogametes, both male and female gametes, are morphologically different. That is, the external structure is different. And the example is fucus. Okay, fucus, the brown algae and human beings. And human beings also is an example. Human beings is an example. Now you will ask me, why, ma'am? Why human beings is an example of heterogamete? Yes or no? Why it is? Because the both male and female gametes of human being is also morphologically different. Yes or no? Where male gamete is sperm or antherozoid, female gamete is egg or the ovum. Ovum is spherical in shape. Yes or no, students? Ovum is a spherical in shape, whereas sperm is an, you have this diagram later. Whereas sperm is in cylindrical or the filament-like structure. Yes or no? It is a filament-like structure, and whereas the egg or the ovum is a spherical in structure. That means morphologically both are different. Yes or no? Morphologically both are different. Do you find any similarities in them? In morphologically external features? No. It is like a filament-like structure, whereas the egg is a, egg or ovum is a round. Okay, egg or ovum is round. So here it become, makes it heterogamete. Here it makes it as heterogamete. So you can write two examples. One example is fucus. Another example is human being. Another example is human. Types of gametes. In types of gametes, there are isogametes. That is iso, the homogametes. Heterogametes or anisogametes. Okay, heterogametes or anisogametes, heterogametes of fucus and heterogametes of human beings. Now, the first one, isogametes. Now, what do you mean by isogametes? Here, what happens? The male gamete and the female gamete are similar. Can you see here? It's of the alga. Yes or no? It's of the alga Cladophora. Yes. Male and female gametes are similar. Okay, example is Cladophora. Okay, can you see any difference over there, students? Can you see any difference between the male and the female gamete? No, right? There is no difference. You say both are very similar. Whereas, now coming to heterogametes. Heterogametes. This is the heterogametes of fucus. Okay, this is the heterogamete of the fucus, the male gamete and the female gamete. Both are similar to you? Can you see there in the picture? Are they both similar to you? Yes? Are they both similar, male and the female gamete? No, right? They are not similar. Male gamete is different, female gamete is different, so it is an heterogamete. Whereas in the human beings also, this is the ovum or the egg. Okay, ovum or the egg. And this is the sperm. Both are different. Both are different. So they are heterogametes. What they are? They are heterogametes. Okay, they are heterogametes. Because ovum is spherical in structure, whereas the sperm is the filamentous. Is it clear to you? Types of gametes? Yes. So this is a major difference. So this is a major difference between the hetero and the homogamete. Remember the examples. Remember the examples. So next, coming to sexuality in the organism. So we'll be studying about the sexuality in the organism, that is, it is a unisexual or bisexual. Okay, unisexual or bisexual, where we also call it as a unisexual, dioecious, or heterothallic. Next one is bisexual, monoecious, or homothallic. So we'll be studying about the sexuality in the organism.